Thanks, Nick. Here on this Android device, we have an activity with an element that we want to change, namely this text field here. So let's switch over to Android Studio to see how we can do this in code. In the project window here, under this folder called values, we have a file called styles.xml. This holds the default theme for this application called app theme. As we can see, we have no customized properties in our app theme. As we can see from this parent property, app theme derives from theme.appcompat.light.darkActionBar. Now let's look at some of the properties that make up this dark action bar theme. So there are a couple of ways to do this. So if we right click and go down to go to and then implementation, or you can control click. So we see the style right here, the theme action compat light dark action bar. That derives from base theme app compat light dark action bar. So if we go to that one, and we can see there are a couple of properties here. Some of the interesting ones here are the color primary dark and the color primary. Now you can go and see what those colors are by doing another control click, and we see right here that that corresponds to a black color. So now that we're back in our styles.xml file, let's create a new style. So in this code right here, we have a style called myStyle that assigns a greenish type color to Android text color. So now that we have our style, let's assign it to an actual element. So if we go back into our project view, let's go to layouts and then activity main. So here's the text view that we previously had that shows up as a grayish color. Let's go in here. So in this text view's declaration, we just need to add this last line here, where we say the style is equal to at style, my style. And that's referring to the style that we created before called my style. One thing that you need to notice is the style property right here isn't appended with an Android colon. So if we go over to the design view, we can see this green color here for our hello world.